Yes, Dean, first of all, you are 53 years old now. Is that correct?
That is correct, Your Honor.
Okay. Quite young dun sa standard ng mga aplikante, di ba?
Opo, tama po.
And if appointed Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, you will serve 17 years.
That is correct, diba? Your Honor.
Kanina, when we were interviewing si yung first na interview dun sa incumbent justice, si Justice Abad, parang very, very clear rin yung stand niya dito eh. At least sa akin. Sinabi niyang, dapa na nga eh. Diba, sabi lang sinabi niya, dapa na ang Court Suprema after impeachment, tapos lalagyan pa ng outsider, lalong dapa, di ba? Dadagdagan pa. Yan ang ating sinabi. So, meaning, yung at least yung sa isa sa mga insiders or incumbent na siyempre pinaprefer nila yung insider for many reasons probably and probably yung isa sa reason doon yung age, isa doon yung experience. So paano mo pupunuan ito, Dean, if ever na ikaw yung ma-appoint or ma-nominate namin muna at ma-appoint, how would you address yung problems na to na, you know, outsider, ito experience yung mga kasama mo doon, matatapakan mo, or hindi naman masasapawan mo yung iba, hindi na magiging Chief Justice. Diba? So, how would you address these problems?
Yes. Thank you, Your Honor, for the question. First of all, hindi ho ako bago sa sitwasyon na yon. I became Dean at the age of 40. My predecessor was then retiring at the age of 65. He belonged to class 58 of the UP College of Law. I was born in 1958. So the gap was rather big. It did not pose any problem to me. My successor also was actually eventually retired in office. So if the question is whether being young comparatively is a disadvantage, it can actually be turned into an advantage. So, for instance, I enjoyed wonderfully the support of my most senior colleagues in the faculty, and they helped me throughout.